Today, I'm going to deliver lecture 13 on null space and column space in linear algebra by Dr. P. Ramlu, Head Department of Mathematics, MBS Government Torsion Science College, Autonomous Mahabubnagar. Up to lectures, we have discussed about the in vector space, so null space, linear independent set, union dependent set, basis, and coordinate vector. Now, I am going to define null space of a matrix and column space of a matrix. First of all, I will discuss about the null space. Later, I will discuss column space. Right? What is null space? What is null space? Here, I am taking that let A be a let A be M cross N matrix. Let A be a M cross N matrix. Then the set of all solutions of Ax equal to 0 bar. Ax equal to 0 bar is called null space of a matrix A. Right, it is denoted by, so that means so the set of all known for right x such that Ax is equal to Ax is equal to 0, right? Here I'm writing this is so so x in this x I'm writing here x belonging to r power n belongs to or power of n. Okay. So this set is called null space of a matrix A. That means it is denoted by null A. It denoted by null A. Right. Let A be M cross N matrix. The set of all solutions of Ax equal to 0 bar is called null space of a matrix A. That means the set of all solutions of Ax bar, this is nothing but the result solutions of Ax equal to 0 bar, x belongs to R power n. This is denoted by null A. Therefore, null A is equal to x belongs to R power such that Ax equal to 0 bar. For example, I want to take that, example, you can take some example, how it is. See here, why? Because I am taking that, Ax equal to 0 bar, nothing but, here my A is M cross N matrix, this is M cross N, if I multiply X with X, that means X must be N cross 1, X must be N cross 1. We will get 0 bar. That is the thing here happening. That's why I'm explaining to R power n, right? Show that some vector. You get either any vector. Show that some vector 1, 0, minus 1. Show that this vector. In this is belong to R3. This belongs to R3 in null A. Where I'm taking that where A equal to you can take that I'm taking like this so here 1, 1, 1. Simply I am taking like this. Right. where a equal to 1, 1, 1. We have to show that this vector is invert. I'm taking here this x. This is called x. This is a. For showing this vector in null A, what can I show? I want to show that Ax equal to 0 bar. For that, let I consider Ax. Here Ax. A nothing but, I'm taking A is equal to in different way, not like that. Here A is my vector, here A is m cross matrix, right? So if I take like this, not possible to apply. Here A I'm taking as 1 cross 3 matrix. That means so, my A is here, why I'm taking like this? So if I do product, I will get this is A is 1 cross 3 matrix. My A is m cross n matrix, right? For A is 1 cross 3, yes, this is 3 cross 1. If I multiply, we will get so for Ax, Ax equal to what happened? A nothing but 1, 1. 1 x nothing but 1 0 minus 1 that equal to 1 plus 0 minus 1 1 into 1 plus 1 into 0 0 1 into minus 1 equal to minus 1. That equal to what happened here? 0. A is equal to 0. So therefore, x belonging to, right? If this is 0 vector, right? Because if I take other matrix, it will be other form, right? If you take a 2 by 3 matrix, you will get here 2 by 3 vector. That means the 0 vector will get. So that means so x equal to 0 bar, this belongs to x belonging to null A. Right? That means the set of all solutions of Ax equal to 0 bar. Here x is the solution of Ax equal to 0 bar. Therefore, x belongs to null A. We shown that 1, 0, minus 1 belongs to R3 is in null A. Right? So similarly, we have discussed some other problems also, right? Null space, I am repeating again here. Let A be a m cross n matrix. The set of all solutions of Ax equal to 0 bar is called null space of a matrix A. Null space of a matrix A, right? It is denoted by null A. Therefore, null A is equal to X such that Ax equal to 0 bar. For x belongs to R4. Example, show that 2, 2, minus 2 belongs to R4n is null A where A equal to 1, 2, 3. Ax equal to A nothing but 1, 2, 3, x nothing but 2, 2, minus 1. If I multiply this, okay, here the matrix right here, this is 1 by 1 matrix, so that what happened here, 2 plus 4 minus 6. That equal to 0, that equal to 0 bar. This is 0 vector, right? Therefore, 1 into 2 equal to 2 into 2 equal to 4, 3 into minus 2 equal to 6. Matrix multiplication, we already we know. That equal to 0 bar, therefore x equal to 2, 2 minus 2 is in null A. X equal to 0 bar, therefore x is in null A. Let A is equal to 1 minus 3 minus 2, or minus 5, 9, 1, and U is equal to 5, 3 minus 2. Determine if U belonging to null A or not. Determine is U in belongs to null A or not. Here my matrix is 2 by 3 matrix. Let given A is 2 by 3, U is equal to this. A U equal to multiply, right? I multiply A U. A nothing but this, U nothing but this. A I equal to here 1 into 5 equal to 5, minus 3 equal to minus 9, minus 2 plus 4. 5 minus 4 that equal to 0. Here minus 5 and minus 25, 9 into 3 equal to 18, 1 into minus 2 equal to 0, 0, 0, that equal to 0, 0, 0, 0, A equal to 0, 0. Therefore, u is equal to pi 3 minus 2 is belonging to null A. A equal to 0, pi will get here, that's why. So, u is equal to pi 3 minus 2 is belonging to null A. Consider the homogeneous equations x1 minus 3 x2 minus 2 x3 equal 0 and minus 5 x1 plus 9 x2 plus x3 equal 0. Then find null space. Okay, we have to find what is null space. Okay, given homogeneous equations are x1, 3x2, minus 2x3 equal 0, minus 5x1 plus 9x2 equal 0. That means if I rewrite this equation in the form of matrix, what we get here? 1 minus 3 minus 2, 1 minus 3 minus 2 into x1, x2. If I multiply this, we will get that 1x1, 3x2, minus 2x3. This equation we get. Here minus 5, 9, 1, that equal to minus 5x1, minus 2, x3, that equal to 0, 0 bar, x equal to 0 bar. Therefore, x equal to x1, x2 is a set of all solutions of given matrix A. X equal to x1, x3 is the set of all solutions of given matrix A. Therefore, x equal to x1 is A, is belongs to null space of A. This element, if I take any x1, x2, x3, okay, of set of all solutions, that means, so if you find that, solutions of this matrix, this is belonging to null space of A, x equal to x1. That means we have to find possible values of x1, x2 such way that which have satisfied these relations. There are infinite solutions. There are infinite solutions. Why? Because variables are 3, equations are 2. That's why we have infinite solutions. Therefore, this element belongs to null space of A. Determined if w is equal to 1, 3 minus 4 is in null A, where A is equal to 3 minus 5 minus 3, 6 minus 2, 0, minus 8, 4, 1. Given matrix A, here A equal to 3 minus 5 minus 3, 6 minus 2, 0, minus 8, 4, 1. This is given matrix. And vector is W, that equal to 1, 3 minus 4, that is belongs to null. I want to show that if I want to derive that, this W is in null A or not. What is null space of A? Null space of A is equal to x such that A equal to 0 power, power x belongs to R power n. Consider AW that equal to 3 minus 5 minus 3, 6 minus 2, 0, minus 8, 4, 1 into 1. If I multiply this 3, 3 into 1, 3, minus 5 into 3, minus 15, minus 3 into minus 3, minus 3 into minus 4, 12. Yeah, this is first vector. Second vector, 6 into 1 equal to 6, minus 20 is equal to minus 6, 0 into 4 equal to 0. Here, minus 8 into 1 equal to minus 8, 4 into 3 equal to 12, 1 into minus 4, minus 4. Here, if you use 3 plus 50, 12 equal to 15, 15 minus 15 equal to 0, minus 6 minus equal to 0, 8 minus 4 minus 12, that equal to 0, that equal to 0 vector. Therefore, A W equal to 0 bar, which implies W belonging to null A. Determine if W equal to in null A, where determine if W equal to is in null A, where A equal to this. The matrix is A equal to 3 minus 5 minus 3, 6 minus 2, 0, minus 8, 4, 1. This is given matrix. And vector is W is equal to 1, 2, 3. Null A equal to x such that A x equal to 0 bar, 4 x belongs to R, 4 n. Consider AW, here AW I am considering. This is AW. If I multiply this matrix, here 3 minus 5 minus 3, 1, 2, 3, multiplying. If I multiply this, 3 into 3, 1 equal to 3, minus 5 into 2 equal to minus 10, minus 3 into 3 equal to 9, 6 into 1 equal to 6, minus 2 into 2 equal to 2 equal to minus 4, 0 into 2 equal to 0, minus 8 into 1 equal to minus 8, 4 into 2 equal to 8, 1 into 3 equal to 3. Here this up to here, minus 19 plus minus 16, 6 minus 4 equal to 2, minus 3. This is not equal to 0, 4. AW equal not equal to 0, therefore W is not in null A. W is not null A. Determine if W is equal to 1 minus 1 is in null A, where A equal to this. Same problem, A equal to 2, 6, 4, minus 3, 2, 5, minus 5, minus 4, 1, W equal to this. Null A is what is this? X was that A equal to 0 bar, X belongs to R, 4, n. AW is equal to 2, 6, 4, minus 3, 2, 5. Here minus 5 minus 4 1, that is 1 minus 1. If I multiply this 2 into 1 equal to 2, 6 into minus 1 equal to minus 6, 4 into 1 equal to 4, minus 3 into 1 equal to minus 3, 2 into minus 1 equal to minus 2, 5 into 1 equal to 5, minus 5 into 1 equal to minus 5, minus 4 into minus 1 equal to 4, 1 into 1 equal to 1, that equal to 0, 0, 0, equal to 0 bar, which implies A W is equal to 0 bar, which implies W is in null A. W is in null A. Theorem. Null space of a matrix A is subspace of R power n. Null space of m cross n matrix A is subspace of R power n. Otherwise, define it. Let A be a m cross n matrix, then null A is subspace of R power n. Let A be a m cross n matrix, then null A is subspace of R power of n. This is a theorem, right? Okay, I want to prove the theorem. So, theorem is, right? What do you prove that? I want to prove that. Let first of all, I would like to take that. Okay. A is m cross n matrix. My A is m cross n. Let A is m cross n matrix, right? I want to show that null A is subspace of all. Null A is subspace of R power of n. I want to show that this element, right? Null A is subspace of R power of n, right? Okay, what is null A? According to definition of null A, what is null A? Null A is equal to what? Null A is equal to X belonging to R power n such that X belongs to R power n such that AX is equal to 0 bar. AX equal to 0 bar. This is the our solution, my solution, right? X equal to AX is equal to 0 bar. So this thing, my null A. I want to show that null A is subspace of R power n. Already we know that subspace theorem, W is non empty subset of R power n, V over vector. Let V over vector space, W is non empty subset of V over F. W is subspace of U or F, if and only if A comma B belongs to F and alpha comma beta belongs to W, which implies A alpha plus B beta belongs to W. This theorem is only. What is this? I am explaining again here. So, V or B a vector space. V or B a vector space. And W is non-empty subset of V. W is non-empty subset of V. Right. W is subspace. W is subspace W is subspace of V. If and only if, what is our condition here? A comma B belonging to A comma B belonging to F alpha comma beta belonging to W, then A alpha plus B beta belonging to W. This theorem already we know that. This theorem we know that, right? Right. So this theorem O. Here I am taking that in place of alpha comma beta, I am some vectors U comma V I will take here. So a comma b belongs to f. I am taking alpha u comma v. I am taking w. Then I want to show that a I u plus b v e belongs to w. If you show that, our is m, alright. Let I am taking two vectors. A comma b belonging to field. This is my field, right? A comma b. You can take that R. Here my field is R. You can take that R. A comma b belongs to F. I want to take that. U comma v belonging to null A. I am taking two element, u comma v belonging to null A. If two element, any element in belongs to null A, which is satisfies the condition is Ax equal to 0 bar. In place of x, what we have here? U comma v. That's why, which implies, this implies here, Au equal to 0 bar. Plus AB equal to 0 bar according to the definition of null space. If I take any element belongs to null A which must satisfy this condition A equal to 0 bar, AB equal to 0 bar, because U is the solution of A, right? This is the element, right? Consider, I want to consider that I want to show that AU plus BV belonging to null A. I want to show that AU plus BV belongs to null A. For showing that AU plus BV belongs to null A, what can I show? I want to show that A times of AU plus BV equal to 0 bar. For showing AU plus BV belongs to null A, I want to show that A times of AU plus BV equal to 0 bar. If it is shown like this, our aim is okay. For that, I am considering. Consider I am considering A times of AU plus BB. I am considering A times of AU plus BV. If it is equal to 0, if this equal to 0 bar, then this element belongs to null A. Right? According to the properties of matrices, what can I here writing? A times of vector space, according to the vector space condition, I will write this plus A times of B. This can be written as, again, A is in scalar here, this can be written as A times of AU plus B times of, I will write here, AB. We can write this here. A times of 0 bar plus B times of 0 bar. This is nothing but 0 bar. This is from star. You can put this is star. You can put the star. From star, what can I write here? A is equal to 0 bar and AB is equal to 0 bar. That's why A 0 bar plus B 0 bar. A 0 bar equal to, already we know the theorems of vector space, with this entry as 0 bar. Plus this also 0 bar. 0 bar plus 0 bar equal to how much here? 0 bar. Right? Which implies what you shown that A times of AU plus BB equal to 0 bar, which implies this element AU plus dv belonging to r power of, sorry, null A belonging to null A. Therefore, A comma B belongs to F, U comma B belongs to null A, which implies A U B B belongs to F for all A comma B belongs to F. And U comma V belonging to null A. So therefore, null A is subspace of R power of N. Null A is subspace of R power M, right? Hence proved theorem. This is the theorem, right? So show that null A is subspace of R power, right? Yes, simply I am explain again. Here A B M cross N matrix, I am taking null A space, null A nothing but this is a subspace of R1 is a vector space, A comma belongs to R, I am taking here, U comma belongs to null A, A equal to 0 bar, A B equal to 0 bar, A times of A equal to considering, that equal to I am show that 0 bar, that means A U equal to 0 bar, which implies A U plus B U null A for all A comma belongs to R and U comma belongs to null A, therefore null A is a subspace of R power N. Hence, null space of a matrix of M cross N matrix A is subspace of R power M. Find the spanning set for, find the spanning set for null space of a matrix. Finding the spanning set of a null space of matrix A is equal to minus 3, 6, minus 1, 1, minus 7. So, 1, minus 2. 2, 3, minus 1, 2, minus 4, 5, 8, minus 4, right? Here A is equal to how much? This is my matrix. Null A is subspace of R4, 5. Here this my matrix is 3 by 5, right? Just now we shown that if A is M cross N matrix, null A is subspace of R power of N, M cross N, right? If A is M cross N matrix, then null A is subspace of R power N. Here my matrix is A is 3 by cross, 3 by 5 matrix, 3 cross 5 by matrix. Then null A is subspace of R power N. Let this is null A subspace of R power N. That's why I am taking that. I want to find that span, find the spanning set for null space of a matrix. This matrix, right? Here, null space of, that means element of null A is, so, is the form of x1, x2, x3, x4 belongs to 5. Null A equal to x such that A is equal to 0 bar, right? Consider A is equal to 0 bar, right? The row reduced argument, I am taking that A is 0. The reduced argument matrix. The row reduced to augmented matrix. Okay. Augmented matrix. A0 I am considering. This is A and this is 0 vector. Here I want to reduce this matrix in echelon form. For that I will get here this is 1. For that what I am doing here? R1 interchanging. So 1, 3, minus 2. What I am doing here? This row is interchanging here. The rows come this side, this row come, right? R1, row 1 interchange, row 2. That is, this row comes this side, this row comes this side. That means, nothing will happen. Okay. For that, I want to get this matrix is 0. For that, what can I do? R2 implies R2 plus 3R1. See, R2 nothing minus 3 plus 3R1. 3R1 nothing but 1. R2 plus 3R1. R3 implies R3 minus 2R1. R3 minus 2R1. Here, 2R1, you will get this 0. If I do operations here, zero, this will be 0, this 0, 5, 10, my, that means, can do that here, I will explain this column, this row, R2 implies R2 plus 3R1. So, for this matrix, what I am doing here, this place, this time of 3 times, I am adding this, minus 3 plus 3, that equal to 0, 6 minus 6 equal to 0, here, and of minus 1 plus 6 equal to 5. 1 plus 9 equal to 10, minus 7, minus 3 is equal to minus 10, 0. Same, you can apply same operation, we get this matrix. R3 implies R3 minus 1 by 5 I am doing here. R3 implies what I am doing here? 1 by 5. R3 implies minus 1 by 5 R2. If I do that, will get this matrix. Okay, see here, if I multiply 2 1 by 5, then what will get here? This will be 1 by 5 nothing but 1, 1 by 5 equals 2, 1 by 5 equals minus 10, that will be both zeros, this will be right. So which implies, what are 1 minus 2, 2 minus 3, 3 minus 1 into this equal to 0, which implies what we get here? X1, this multiply this row by this, we will get this, multiply this, we will get this. So from this x1 equal to what happened? 2x2 minus 2x3 plus 3x4. And x3 is equal to from this here, from this equation, x3 is equal to minus 2x4 plus 2x5. This substitute this value in this equation. Substitute x3 in this equation. X1 equal to what happened? 2x1, 2 times of minus 2x4 plus 4 plus 3x4 this square. If I simplify this, therefore x equal to x1, x2, x3, x4, x5. Therefore, x equal to what happened? 2x4 plus x3, x4. This from x1 equal to, from simplify this, 2x2. You can see, observe here, minus into 2 into 2 plus 4x4 minus 3x4, this is x4. Minus 4x5 plus x5 equal to 3x5. This is minus 3x, minus 3x5. X nothing but x4. X3 nothing but minus 2x4 plus 2x5. X4 nothing but x4, x5. Right? Therefore, that equal to, this is in the form of, like this I am writing. This means, here, the x1 is gone and x3 is gone. These are the matrix in the term of x2, x4, x5. That's why I am writing like this. I am taking common out x2 here. X equal to x2 common out here. From this, what we get here? 2, 1, 0, 0, 0. If I take x4 common out, 1, 0, minus 2. That means this matrix is in form of writing. If I multiply, we will add him, we will get the same matrix. If I multiply this and adding this equation, we will get the same matrix. So, I am rewriting this matrix in the form like this. We have vector, these vectors, right? That means the null space is spanned by the matrix. The null space is spanned by the matrix, these vectors. Here, 2 minus 2 whole cube, 3 minus 3, 1 plus 2. Let P3 be a vector space. Given polynomials are this. B1 equal to 8 minus 1, B2 equal to this, B3 equal to this. So, A equal to this. What could, okay, so the problem, okay, this problem already for sure, I want to show whether this is linear dependent and independent or vectors, the polynomial. These kind of problems already I explained in last lecture, here, okay, no need to write here, this problems already we solved there. Column space. These problems already we solved in last lecture. Okay. Column space. Let A is equal to B1, B2, Bn bar. So be a matrix. So then the set of linear combination of matrix is called column space. Let A be a M cross N matrix. Here A nothing but B1 bar, B2 bar, that is Bn. Be a M cross N matrix. Then the set of all linear combination of A matrix is called column space. It is denoted by column A. Therefore, column A equal to B such that B bar is equal to AX for X belongs to R power N. Right? So, if A equal to B1 bar, then column A equal to span of B1, B2 that as Bn bar. If A is equal to B1 bar, B2 bar, that is Bn bar, then column A equal to span of B1, B2, that is Bn bar. Where each Bi is M cross 1 matrix. You can observe clearly here. Why? Because my A is M cross N matrix. That means it has M rows and N columns. Here we have N column, no doubt. For getting A is M cross matrix, that each Bi has here M cross 1 vectors. Or each Bi column of matrix A. Okay. So, this thing. Again, I explain here. So, we will quickly explain here. Suppose, already we have, okay, not right, again, suppose A is B1, B2, mm-hmm. A is the matrix A, so, we are B1, B2, that as dn the matter, right? So column A equal to what happened here? Column A is nothing but column A equal to B such that AX equal to B. AX equal to. That means column A nothing but here span of these vectors B1, B2, as Pn. This is span, right? It is look like span L of S like this, right? Here my A is M cross N matrix. A is M cross N matrix. So here I'm taking sorry. Here A is M cross N matrix, right? So not set. A is M cross N matrix. This is M cross N matrix. So here B belonging to B belongs to R power of M. B belongs to R power of M. So this is column space. I want to show that if column space is subspace of R power of M. I want to show that column space is subspace of R power M theorem. Okay. Let A be M cross N matrix, then the column space of M cross N matrix A is subspace of R power M. Let A be a M cross N matrix, then the column space of M cross N matrix is subspace of R power M. Or again, I will define A is M cross N matrix, then column A is subspace of R power M simply. Let A is, if A is M cross N matrix, then column A is subspace of R power M. Let R power M R be a vector space. Let R power M R be a vector space. Let A be M cross N matrix. I am taking that A equal to B1 bar, B2 bar, add as Bn bar, where each Bi is M cross N matrix or vectors. You can take that. We know that column A equal to span of B1 bar, B2 bar, add as Bn bar. By the previous theorem, already we know that column A equal to span B is subspace of R power M. Column A is a subspace of R power M, right? So let this thing is very subspace of R power M. Right. Okay, I will show again. Column A is span is a space of R power M. Already been shown that span of is a space of R power M. Already been shown. Okay. So now I am taking that. Let V over be a vector space. L of S equal to gamma gamma one equals that equals span of S. Alpha gamma beta belongs to L of S and span of U1 equal to U1. Then alpha belongs to S, beta equal to this. A gamma belongs to F, alpha alpha plus beta belongs to this. Okay. This theorem, okay, already we shown that. Here, last row, by previous theorem, we have proved this. Span of B1, B2 is subspace of R power M. By similarly, I am also, that means the theorem is L of is subspace of R power M. That is, span of this is subspace of R power M. Here, what you take that? We can take that alpha comma beta belongs to column A. That equal to alpha equal to what happened here? Alpha equal to a1 b1 plus like this. The in place of span of you can any vectors. So I am taking that alpha equal to beta belongs to L of S, that equals column A. You have to take that two elements of column A. So simply can I will explain here. So for showing that I want to show that column A is subspace of R power M. Column A is subspace of R power N, right? What is column A? Column A is equal to span of B1 bit, right? That equal to span of B1 bar, B2 bar, Bn bar. I want to show this column A is subspace of R power M. That means R power M is a vector space. I am taking two comma vectors alpha comma beta belonging to or u comma v, can take that A u b, right? I take that A comma B belongs to F or R. Okay, take that real number set also R4M over R4 plus, right? Yeah, and U comma V belonging to column A. If any vectors in a vector, it is span of B1 bit, right? That means, what can I write here? U times of what can I write here? A1 B1 bar plus A2 B2 bar dash 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 plus AN BN bar. That means it is a linear combination vector sub, right? If I take V is equal to column A, that equal to M, what we write here? I am writing C1 B1 bar plus CN BN bar. I am writing this. If vector belongs to column A, it is in the form like this, U comma V. AU plus BV, I am considering that, I want to show that AU plus BV belonging to column A. For this, I have considered this. Here, A nothing but A times of U nothing but this vector. Plus B times of that vector. B nothing but this vector. Here, also, okay, I want to take this vector in here. This is a u, this is v, right? After simplifying this, what we get here? After simplifying this, a1 b1 bar a1 plus b1 bar plus dash 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 plus AN bar BN bar. Next to same as this, so here you also write B C1 bar C1 B1 bar dash 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 so B CN into BN bar. If I add these things by, see, since we are a vector space, if it is come this side for taking out, apply all vector space condition, since R overall vector space. So, for coming this year, it will take associative and abelian properties and shift properties. So, from this you can come out here easily by using apply property, vector space properties only. Right? Here I am taking that A1. A1 plus BC1 times B1 bar plus AN plus BCN to BN bar. Okay. See, you can observe this is B1, B2 bar, that is BN bar. These are scalars A1, B, B, C1 belongs to scalars. Scalar into some B1 plus scalar into some B2, scalar into B1. This all belongs to F, which implies it is span of, it's equal to red as, so it is linear combination of B1 dash vectors, right? That means this element to AU plus BV belonging to, can take that column A or span of B1. Column A. That equal to span of B1, right? In a combination of B1, B2, that is BN bar. So AU plus BV belongs to column A for all A comma B belonging to F or R, whatever may be, and U comma V belonging to column E. Therefore, column E is a subspace of R power over M. Okay. If column space of A matrix is subspace of R power over, then what is K? If column space of a matrix is subspace of R power K, then what is K? Where K is here, A is what? 2, 4, right? This is which matrix? 3 by 3 by 4 matrix, right? We know that if A is M cross N matrix, then column space is subspace of R power of M only. In place of M, what we have here? 3. Therefore, A is 3 by 4 matrix, M is equal to 3. The column space of A is subspace of R power 3. Therefore, K is equal to 3. Here, he asked that if column space of A is subspace of R power, then what is K? Where A is equal to this. He has given that A is equal to this matrix. This is 3 by 4 matrix. Already we know that if A is M cross N matrix, then column space of A is subspace of R power M. Just now you have proved theorem. Where A is 3 by 4 matrix, M is equal to 3. Therefore, column space of A is subspace of R power 3. Therefore, K is equal to 3. Check one. If null space of A is subspace of R power K, then what is K? Just now we already proved that if A is M cross N matrix is null space of A, then A is subspace of R power M. Column space subspace of R power M, null space subspace is R power N. Where A is M cross 3 by 4 matrix, N is equal to 4, null space of A is subspace of R power 4, therefore K is equal to 4. Okay. If column space of A is subspace of R power, then what is K? Here for the following, okay. Here I want to that if column space of A is subspace of R power K, then what is K? The matrices are here, A is given. Same by using these properties already, we just now we proved that. Same properties, you can show that. See, if I take this matrix, what happen? If A column space of A is R power K, this matrix is, what is this matrix? 4 by 2 matrix. This 4 by 2 matrix. If A is M cross N matrix, column space subspace of R power M. Here A is 4 by 2 matrix. A is 4 by 2 matrix. Then column space of is subspace of R power 4. Column space of A is subspace of R power 4. K is equal to 4. If I take this, a 4 by 3 matrix. This is 4 by 3 matrix. Column space subspace of 4 only, R power 4 only, K is equal to 4. If I take this matrix, this is 2 by 4 matrix. This is 2 by 4 matrix. Therefore, column space of A is subspace of R power 2. That means K is equal to 2. If I take 1 by 5 matrix, the column space of subspace of R power 5 only. Sorry, R power 1 only. That means K is equal to 1. Null space of A is subspace of R power, then what is K? Here, I know that if A is M cross N matrix, the null space of A is subspace of R power of N. Here, A is 4 by 2 matrix, then null space of A is subspace of R power 2. That is K equal to 2. This my matrix is 4 by 3. We know that this matrix subspace, the null A subspace of R power 3, K equal to 3. This is my matrix is 2 by 4. Therefore, 2 by 4 matrix. That's why it is subspace of R power 4. Null A subspace of R power 4, K equal to 4. This 1 by 5, null space subspace of R power 5, here K equal to 5. Right? This is the similarly, just now we have discussed by use that only you can do your own. So this thing I have already explained. Every matrix A is 2 by 5 matrix, M is equal to color space of A is subspace of R power M, K equal to null A is A is subspace of R power 10, A is subspace A is 2 by 5 matrix, therefore N equal to 5, K equal to 5. Like this, just now already explained. So simply you can do it. Let A equal to 2, 4, minus 2, 1, minus 2, minus 5, 7, 3, 3, 7, minus 8, 6, U is equal to minus 3, 2, V equal to this. Determine if U is in null A, could U in B column A? Determine if U is in null A, could U in B column A? Determine if V is in null A, could V in column A? So, given matrix A is this 2, 4, minus 2, 1, minus 2, right? This matrix. U is equal to 3, minus 2, 1, V is equal to 3, minus 1. What is null A? Null A is equal to X such that A is equal to 0 bar for X belongs to R. Column A is equal to B such that B equal to X for all b bar such that b bar equal to ax for all x belongs to R power n. Consider AU. Consider AU. That equal to what happened here? Will be 0. Is not equal to 0. 2, 4, minus 2, we multiply this. This will not, you are inputting here, not equal to 0. That be AU not equal to 0. Therefore, this U is not in null A. I want to verify U is in null A. Could U in null column A? So, I will verify that whether this belongs to null A or column A, right? So, U is not in null A. Since A is 3 by 1 matrix, A is 3 by 4 matrix, we know that column is a subspace of R power 3. But U is equal to 3 minus 2 minus 1 0. That is, this is has 4 coordinate. Only column A is a subspace of R power 3. Why? Because if A is m cross n matrix, then column A is a subspace of R power m. Here in place of m, what we have m? Column A is a subspace of R power 3. Therefore, V is equal to 3 minus 2 minus 1 has 4 coordinate. This is not in column A. B. Null A is equal to x such that A is equal to 0 bar for x belongs to R power n. Column A equal to B. B such that B for x belongs to R power n. I am taking that AB. AB is equal to what happened? 2, 4, 9, 7. If I multiply this, so if I take that to AB, that equal to what happened here? 2, 4 minus 2, 1. It's not possible, but multiplication, right? Null A is a space of R power 4, but V is equal to 3 minus 4 has only 3 coordinates. Here, if any vector belongs to null A, it must have 4 coordinates. That means, here my matrix is, so this is 3 by 4. Null A is a space of R power 4. Here we have only 3 coordinates. It must have 4 coordinates. If it is not 3 coordinates, that means V does not belong to null A. V does not belong into null A. Unable to find null A here. Why? Because the elements of null A must be 4 coordinates, but V is 3 coordinates. That this does not belong to null A. Column A is a space of R power 3. Therefore, consider AX equal to V bar, B bar, you can take anything where X equal to this. And doing that, AX equal to B bar, X equal to A1, A2. Right? Okay, multiply this, we will get this by solving this. Equation, so you can do what? Okay, solve this equation. So, okay, by already with this kind of problems already result by solving this equation. So, we will get the values a3 equal to 1 and of a4 equal to 1 by 17. Okay, you can solve this matrix, right? We will get the answers are a1 equal to this, a2 equal to this, a3 equal to this, a2, right? By solving this matrix, we will get this solution, right? So, therefore, since V is linear combination of A such that AX equal to V bar, then V is null, is in null space of A. Sorry, column space of A. E is in column space of A. Okay. Find the matrix A such that W equal to column A. Right. Find a matrix A such that W is equal to column A. Where W is equal to this, BA minus B, A plus 7A. A comma belongs to R. W is equal to what happens? 6A minus B, A plus B minus 7A, such that A comma belongs. W is equal to 6A minus B, A plus B minus 7A. I am taking A comma out here. What happened here? 6, 1, minus 7. If I take B comma out here, minus 1. If I see multiply adding this only, so A 6, 1, minus 7, B times are minus 1, 1, 0. It is a linear combination of this and this. Therefore, span up this element and this, therefore, column A. A is equal to 6, 1, minus 7, minus 1, 1, 0 is the matrix. A is equal to 6, 1, minus 7, minus 1, 1, 0 is the matrix, right? So, that means we have to find a matrix such that W go column A. That's why my matrix is this. Similarly, you can find the matrix A such that W equal to column A. Where W is equal to this, so this matrix 2S plus T, R minus S plus 2, 3S, such that R comes comes to plus R. W is equal to B minus C, 2B plus 3D minus 2, C, A, B, C, D plus to R. W, I am taking that, W is this, my W matrix, same I am taking here. This matrix can be written as R times of this and S times of this and W times this. It is a linear combination of this element, the span of this, so this element, therefore A is equal to what happened here? 0, 1, 3, 2, 2 minus 1, 1, 0, right. You can take W also, W is equal to B minus C, I am taking B, C, D comma note. If I multiply with this, this is a linear combination of this vector, this vector, this vector, this is vector. It is span of this vector, this vector, this vector. Therefore, A equal to 1, 2, minus 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 3, 1, 0, 3, 3, minus 3, 1, right? Okay, so this is column A. Similarly, same method, you can solve this problem. So, you get W equal this. Okay, by using this condition, you can rewrite these equations. We will find that matrix A, right? Either use appropriate theorem or following sets W show that given set of W is subspace of find specify example for contradictory. Okay. In last classes already we in this lecture already explained to you can do that whether this is span, that means you can write your span or column space of A, that thing. This will be subspace of the nullier column A, will get that thing, right? Okay. So thank you for watching this lecture. Thank you one and all for watching this.